Greetings to all. This is a section on linkage and crossing over. So as we have discussed in the previous presentations, when we discussed about Mendel's laws of inheritance, the third law of independent assortment states that when the gamete formation happens, the two alleles for one gene, they segregate or they assort independently of the alleles for the other genes, right? But some pattern of inheritance do not follow the similar Mendelian inheritance, as in the genes who are found on same chromosome, they do not assort independently and they are inherited together. Therefore, they are said to be linked. So the genes that are sufficiently close together, packed compactly on a chromosome, they tend to stick together and they tend to be inherited as a pair during this meiosis phase of sexual reproduction. And this phenomenon is called as genetic linkage. So depending on the types of distance, the distance between the linked genes in a chromosome, there are three types of genetic linkages observed commonly. Firstly is a complete linkage, wherein the genes are located very closely together on the same chromosome. They could not be separated by the process of recombination or crossing over during meiosis, as we'll be discussing in the later slides. It consistently appears in two or more generations in their parental combinations. So that is when it's called as a complete linkage. The second form is incomplete or partial linkage, wherein the genes are located far apart on the same chromosome. They undergo an accidental or an occasional breakage of chromosomal segments during the process of crossing over, and therefore they could be easily separated by the process of recombination. And when they're recombining, therefore, they're also producing some percentage or some proportion of the non-parental combination in the next generations. The third category is absent or non-detectable linkage, wherein the genes are located very, very far apart on the chromosome and they can easily undergo recombination procedures. So what exactly is the process of crossing over? It's also called as recombination. During the prophase 1 of meiosis, these linkage genes, as we were discussing, they could be separated. They do not always remain like that. They could be separated, especially in the prophase 1 of meiosis. And when this physical exchange of equal pieces of adjacent non-sister chromatid happens, that process is called crossing over or recombination. During this process, one of the paired chromosome arms, They are exchanged physically at one or more locations. And when the crossing over across chromatids break at chiasma and they are reattached at a different homologous chromosome, the chromatids that result out of the interchange of the segments, they are called as the crossover recombinants. And therefore, the chromatids that remain intact are the non-crossover parental chromatids. For instance, in this diagram, in the first category, when there is no crossing over happening and the daughter cells are quite much identical to the parent cells, we can easily identify that there is no process of recombination in the formation of the gametes. Whereas in the other case, when from the parents during the meiosis phase, there was the exchange of chromatid arms and the daughter nuclei form are very much not identical to the parent cells. Therefore, because it's causing certain form of genetic variation, we can implicate that there has been crossing over taking place during the process of meiosis. Now, there are different types of crossing over again. So, depending on the number of points where the exchange is happening, so for instance, when the chiasma is formed at a single point, it's called as a single crossing over. In case when there are two points, it's called as a double crossing over. And there could be more than two, there could be three, there could be four, there could be five, like three within the two and one, two on the outer chromosomes. So there could be multiple forms of crossing overs that can take place. But it's generally observed that multiple crossing over are quite rarely observed. The single and double crossing over, they generally are the common forms of crossing over. Now there are certain factors that affect crossing over. For instance, the mutation tends to reduce the process of crossing over. Okay, so that could be one factor. The age could be a factor because some researchers have proved that older age increases the rate of crossing over. Some researchers also say that temperature variations cause a difference of certain percentage of crossing over in certain parts of chromosomes again. Considering the sex of the person, there is a reduced tendency of crossing over in male mammals as compared to the females. Now, also the X-ray radiations can increase the process of crossing over, especially near the centromere. So these are certain factors that could affect the process of crossing over. Now, what is the significance of this process of both the linkage and the crossing over? So in case of linkage, we see that it's an effect of the selection that is coming out. So it's promoting genetic variation to some extent. And most importantly, it maintains the characters being passed from one generation to not just one generation alone, it passes to many generations if the location of the gene is very compactly packed together on a chromosome, right? On the other hand, crossing over process produces new combination of traits, right? There is origin of new characters that could be observed. There is genetic variation for sure. And there is an important role that is observed in the breeding pattern, or say when we are talking about eugenics. So crossing over has a real big significance in that case. Now the differences when we talk of linkage, the genes have the tendency to remain together and pass on to the next generation as a single unit. Whereas when we talk of crossing over, the linkages, the compatibility is broken down and they form new linkages and they produce recombination, which are more or less not like the parental characters. They are new form of characters. On the other hand, the linkage produces more or less the parental characters. Now, the strength of the linkage, it increases with the compactment or the close placement, whereas the crossing over frequency decreases if they are very closely placed. And linkage maintains a newly improved trait within the generations, whereas crossing over is a source of genetic variation for producing a new variety. So this was more or less about linkage and crossing over. You can give a small write-up on these practice questions. Please try to avoid copying down as it is from the write-up or the video. Try to understand the process and write down in your own understanding, in your own words, so that your understanding is much better for these concepts. These are very basic concepts, so just try to build your own understanding on it. Thank you for your time. See you in the next video.